Hello guys! Today, I will show how to configure Maven and jacoco to obtain the test coverage for both the unit and the integration tests. So, let's dig into the Maven plugins. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button and let's start. First of all, I've created some integration tests. I took the unit tests from the controllers, changing the mocks by bins, the H2 database as done in the repository unit tests. I've added the security configuration to have all the HTTP filters configured before the controllers. This way, to reach a controller, I need to authenticate the request. And now, how to identify an integration test, how to differentiate it from the unit tests. I've named them with the IT integration test suffix. And now, let's configure the Surefire and Failsafe Maven plugins. Why do I need those plugins? The Surefire plugin is the one dedicated to run the unit tests. If a single test fails, it will stop the complete Maven build, because the unit tests are mandatory for the correct behavior of the application. If a single unit test fails, it means that the application isn't stable. On the other side, the Failsafe plugin will be used to run the integration test. Why? Because it will run all the integration tests and list the result at the end. And if there is almost a single integration test which fails, the Maven build will end with an error code. This is a separated goal that I may or may not add. How to configure them? I will filter the integration tests in the Surefire plugin to run only the unit tests, because the Surefire plugin is configured by default to run all the tests present in the test rules folder. On the other side, the Failsafe plugin has an already configured filter to run only the integration tests, those ending by it.java. This way, I have the Surefire, which is only dedicated to the unit tests, and Failsafe, which is only dedicated to the integration tests. There are two Maven goals: test and integration test. The Surefire plugin will be scoped to the test goal. This is already the default behavior. And for the Failsafe plugin, I must scope it to the integration test goal. Let's open and edit the POM XML to configure those plugins. I take the version information from the Spring Boot parent dependency. This is the goal which will run the integration tests. And this is to verify that the integration tests run correctly. This is what will return a failure message for the Maven build. Just two plugins, and I have the unit tests and the integration tests running with Maven in separated goals. Easy, right? Next step, jacoco to generate the report about the coverage. But how does jacoco work? jacoco has an agent, which will be connected while running the test. This agent will inspect which lines of code are run, which branch, which method, which classes were executed during the test. And at the end, it will compare how many lines of code were run and how many were missed. What I must do is plug this agent before the test starts and generate a report when the test phase finishes. I must do it for both the unit and the integration test phases. So, when running the Surefire and Failsafe plugins, I must add an agent. I must accept a new argument. And now, jacoco. I will exclude those classes because they have no business logic. I only want to be sure to test all the classes which have some business logic. And now, let's build the Maven project. And the reports are located at target, site, jcoco, both unit and integration tests. Let's open the report. Here I can see how much code is covered by the unit tests and by the integration tests, how many branches, methods, or classes are tested or missed, and I can navigate to see which specific line isn't covered. Here I see the lines which are not covered in red and the branches which are partially covered in yellow. Do you want more? I've even used this script in my CI/CD pipelines to avoid having the coverage decreasing under a certain limit. With this command, I obtained the percentage coverage, 51. With some simple checks in bash, I can return a failing status if the number is under a specific limit. Let's say it's under 80%. You can find this command in the video's description. Of course, this can be done with more advanced tools like SonarQube. But I need to put it in place, and this is a reasonable starting point to maintain the stability of my application. That's all for today. I will just ask you to click on the thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to follow my videos. Bye!